Welcome back again, Scoopies.com. In the last video, we have explained regarding what is the triangles and what we are dealing in triangles from whenever our mathematics started and when geometry we started actually in the third or fourth classes. And that time we learned about the shape, means what type of triangles, what type of circle would be. And we compare those things with our real life example, like to compare the bulb like with the circles, sun is like the circles, and some rectangular prisms which are keeping in that office. So those we are comparing for the triangles. Okay. So those we are learning in the junior classes. Again, we started in that high school, means from the sixth classes. We start explaining regarding what type of triangle is. Whatever triangle means, suppose we can say a triangle in terms of sides and triangle in terms of angles, means how that triangle is divided in different sections and what are the points we need to keep in our mind when we are explaining regarding the triangles. So that we all explained the last sections, and today we are going to explain what we have after 8 class. Suppose we include some topic regarding, like suppose till now we discussed regarding types of triangles, and types of triangle is divided into parts. First part based on angles, and second part that is based on sides. So that we discussed with about those things. Based on angles, we divided in acute angles. Acute angle means all the angles of triangle which is less than 90 degree. If all the angles of triangle is less than 90 degree, then we can call it as a acute angle triangle. Second one, if we discuss about obtuse angle triangle, that is at least one angle must be more than 90 degree. That is at least one angle is more than 90 degrees. And the third one is right angle triangle. Third one is right angle triangle. So here, right angle triangle means any one angle must be equal to 90 degrees. This is the partition based on the angles. These are the partition based on the angles. Similarly, we discussed about the based on the side also, and we called it as the first triangle, the equilateral, that is triangles. So equilateral triangles means if all sides are same, they can call it as equilateral triangles. Next is your isosceles triangles, that is based on when two arms are same and base are unequal, means only any two sides are same, then you can call it as a isosceles triangle. Third one is stellene triangles. Stellene triangles means when all sides are different. You can't say means all sides. This is different. So we can call it as a stellene triangles. Okay, these we discussed before in last video also. So thus we are recalling what we discussed in the last class. Now today we are going to discuss about the properties related to. Suppose what we have in our 9 class levels. Okay. So see, today we will discuss about similarities and congruence, which is very important right now because of that foundation batch in the medical and that IIT engineering. They are including those things in 6th classes onwards. What is congruence, similarity? So these things, when they reach 9th class and 10th classes, basically they know everything about that. So today I'll discuss about that. What is the similarity and what is congruence, and one by one we will discuss on each and every topic. So to see similarity, what is a similar triangle? Similar triangles, and next one is congruent triangles. Congruent triangles. What is the similar triangles and congruent triangles, and what is the relation between them, and what are the consequences here, and what are the things which is which can be congruent, which cannot be similar, or similar which similar we cannot be congruent. We discuss on those things. So, see, similarities means shapes. If it is shapes are same for any triangles, if you are saying shapes are same, then we can simply say that it is similar. Suppose if I am saying other triangle, if it is a small or big, no matter. If it is a both are triangle, means shape are same. If I am saying shape is same, shape will be same. Same means no difference in shape. And you can call it as if I am saying about the circle. This is a circle. This is small circle. This also a circle. This also a circle. Shapes are same. We can call it as a similar figures. We can call it as a similar figures, and we can say in a triangle form. We can say the similar triangles. Here one more point is important. If they are same, if they are similar, means their sides are their and triangles are all either proportional. So we can say sides are proportional. Sides are proportional in the sense. Proportional. That means sides are proportional means we can say suppose this is 2 cm and this is a 4 cm. This is 4 cm. So this will be the 2 cm. This is 6 cm. We can say this is 3 cm. And this is 8 cm. Suppose this will be the 4 cm. So how we can say this is this ratio is the same means if I do 4/2, suppose 2/4, this angle by this angle. 2/4 and this side means 3/6. This side means 4/8. If I cancel, we can get the same value, that is 1/2, 1/2. So what we are saying, all are the same. Means these are the proportion. Means the sides are in proportion with the means. If that base is increasing, how much they are increasing based on that, so we can increase. Or else we can see. We can take the photograph. Suppose when we take the photograph, then suppose that perfect photograph will be this size. That's it. So perfect photo when we click, will get in this size. Suppose. So if I do what I do, if I elongate that photo in the downward side, when I let's pull this thing from the edge in the computer, how will see that the faces like in the cone shape, the faces will become the cone type in the sand. So that all faces like nose, ear, it will look like a different, we will look like the aliens, correct? So we can't say that will be the proportion. Means if it is a proportion, means I have elongated that photo in the both way such that the pictures should be picture should look nice. Understand? We can say that that are the proportion. Okay, then we can say that will be the proportion. Means we stretch the photo in such a way that nothing is changing that photograph. Just we get the enlarge for that photo. Understand? And regarding means different aspect, there is nothing is changes. How I said about when we pull in one side. That face will become like a cone shape, their eyes will be looking different, their nose will be looking different. So that is not is a kind of proportionality. It means we are not maintaining the proportionality. That's why that figure becomes this figure. Understand? So these are the things regarding proportionality. Okay. We have the topic in that RS, those were mentioned in that international schools, those were using international schools. That ratio and proportion one topic we can discuss on that after completing this this thing. Okay. So these are the similar triangles. Similar properties of similar figures. Triangles means shape will be the same. Shape will be the same. If it is shapes are different, we can't say they are both are the similar figures. And the sides are proportional. Ten sides are proportional. And practically, if we check that will be the similar or not. Just keep one triangle on another triangle, it will be look like same irrespective of their sizes. Size it can be a different size, but the shape will be the look like the same. Okay, so this type of thing you can get in the similar figures. What is the congruent figure? Congruent figures means that things must be similar. First point, that figure must be must be similar. This is the first point. If it is similar figure or similar thing, either it was a triangle, it was a circle, it was a quadrilateral, first thing must be the similar. They must be the similar. And here size also be same. That is the main point in the congruent figures. If this is the main point, that the figure must be similar and the size must be the same. If it is, and one just add one more point. If you keep one figure on another, that will superimpose each other. That means, suppose these two triangles I have. If I keep one triangle on another triangle, suppose one and two are two triangles are there, I'll keep one triangle on two, suppose. That two will be not visible here. One only will be visible because that triangle one cover triangle two perfectly from all the sides, all the corners. It will be look like the one triangle. That means superimposed means that two triangles superimposed to each other. If it is superimposed to each other, we can say sides will be the same and the figure will be the congruent. Okay. So these are the things we are dealing with similar triangles and the congruent triangles. So okay, next week we will see about the what is there in the similar triangle and what is there in the congruent triangles and what are the types of those things and what is the relation. Okay. So till then, thank you everyone. We'll meet in the next video. And please go and watch the question. Go and watch the videos and. More and more sign up there, so you can get the quality of questions in that. And we're trying to add a different whatever performance, how you are going to respond that one. So based on that, we'll add different even subject questions also. Okay, so please sign up and logging that one and try more and more questions on that. Okay, thank you everyone.
सर हो गया सर सर पवन सर
सर
हाँ हो गया सर पवन सर पवन सर
हेलो
सर है सर
हेलो
सर है सर सुनाई दे रहा
हाँ सुनाई दे रहा आप स्टॉप कर दो इसको
हाँ आप कंटिन्यू कीजिए
कंटिन्यू करूँ
हाँ हाँ
क्योंकि लंबा हो जाएगा ना फिर इसलिए बोल रहा
हूँ नहीं नहीं लंबा नहीं होगा
गैप कर लेते हैं स्टार्ट करूं
हाँ स्टार्ट करिए सर नेक्स्ट वीडियो भी स्टार्ट कर
दो तो सो So in the last welcome back again in our channel stupquiz.com. In the last video we discussed about the similar thing, what is a similar triangle and congruent triangle, and what type of things must be needed to become the similar, and what are the things needed for the congruent triangle. So we discussed about the definition part of similar triangle, the definition part of congruent triangle. So in the last lecture, that important point that we I didn't say because that must be required in the now. So at least you can remember what I discussed in the last lecture. Okay. So I said in congruent triangle, what I discussed, the thing must be similar. First, the triangle must be similar triangle. That means from here we can understand. So, video off, sir. Okay. आप बोले भी नहीं, मैं स्टार्ट कर दिया था. वेलकम बैक अगेन इन ओके वेलकम बैक अगेन इन आवर चैनल stupquiz.com. एंड इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट the similar triangles and the congruent triangles, what are the definitions part of the similar triangles and congruent triangles, and what are the criteria that must be needed to become the similar triangles and the congruent triangles. Okay. So in the last lecture what I discussed means one point I didn't discuss because in this lecture also we need that thing to understand the next part. Okay. So see what I said in the last section. So congruent triangle, first most important condition is that must be similar. Triangle must be the similar triangle. The triangle must be the similar. Then only we can say that it can be a congruent. So from this we can conclude one note point. Is that all similar triangles all congruent triangles are similar. If I say about the Venn diagram, suppose let it be this will be the congruent triangle. So this will be a similar triangle. This is a congruent triangle. See, this will be a similar triangle. The more conditions are satisfied to make the congruency, but whatever similar triangle is there, that must be congruent triangle. Okay, or congruent triangles, all similar triangles. Okay, so all congruent triangles, we can say that will be the similar triangle. Now, see one important point. So now we will discuss about the types of similar triangles. Similar triangles. Okay, the Venn diagram, what I discussed, the congruency for the triangles, that can be all congruent triangles are similar means this will be the similar triangles, this will be the congruent, we can keep it as, because all congruent triangles are similar, but all similar triangles are need not be the congruent. Okay, so all congruent triangles are similar, but all similar triangles need not be the congruent. We can say like that. Suppose I discussed those points. Why that all similar triangles can not be the congruent, but all congruent triangles must be the similar. Okay, the types of similar triangles. If I say discuss types of similar triangles, is first type is AA criteria, or we can say AAA criteria. That means both are the same. if two angles of any triangles are same. So based on that only they prove Pythagoras theorem, means sum of two side square equals to the third side square. And based on this A criteria only we can solve the Pythagoras theorem also. So this is the first means, if I able to prove two triangles suppose are same, two angles are same, suppose these two angles are same for these two triangles, we can say these two triangles are similar. This is sign of similarity. Sign of similarity means this is sign of congruency. I'll tell you on that one. So if I'll say this is A B C triangle and this is P Q R, if two angles, if I'm saying angle A equals to angle P and angle B is equals to angle Q, then by AA similarity triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. You can say like that. Okay, if two triangles are having two angles are same, then we can say that two triangles are similar. So this is the first criteria, that is the AA or AAA criteria. Okay. Now we'll do the next one, that is the triple S criteria. Triple S criteria, that means side criteria. Side similarity. Side similarity. That means if I'm saying if a triangle A B C is similar to triangle P Q R, suppose, then we can say suppose AB length equals to PQ. This is nothing but side. Okay. Again, BC must be equals to QR. This is also side, and AC equals to PR. That is also equals to side. So by seeing this, if all three sides are same, so by SSS criteria triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. So from this we can say these two triangles ABC are similar to triangle PQR. If all the sides of the triangles are same, then we can say these two triangles must be the similar. So this is the second part of the criteria. Next, side angle criteria. That means if two triangles are having, suppose A, B, C, P, Q, R. So this is a triangle A, B, C and P, Q, R. We are saying two angles are same and the side, one side must be the same. But we can't choose the same, means or any one side. Understand? Here we can't choose any one side. That means suppose if I'm choosing angles B and C, here Q and R. Means if I'm choosing two angles from one triangle, then the side I need to choose in between two triangles. Only this side I need to choose. So that is the meaning behind it. S must be included between two angles. S must be included between two angles. So that's why they mention ASA criteria. So if I'm saying angle B is equal to angle Q, that is the angle. Okay. Again, BC is equals to angle BC side equals to angle side QR. This is a side because that side is included between angle B and angle C and angle Q and angle R. So and angle C equals to angle R. That is also angle. So from this criteria, we can say angle side angle criteria. I can say triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. So like that we can say about this also. if it is two angle which is in included angle between included side between two angles are same, then we can simply we can say that these two triangles are similar and similar triangles. Okay, so this is all about the similar figures that we have in the 10th classes. Okay, so we will discuss the question in the next one also. What type of questions you are going to get in that one. And first we will discuss about the congruent triangle. And once we completed the congruent triangle, we can see about questions on similar triangles and congruent triangles together. And we will solve some properties, some theorem also, like Pythagoras theorems are there in the class, and which is very important in terms of CVC board exam. Basic proportionality theorems are there, that is also very important. So many such things are there. We will discuss based on that similarities and congruence in the next video. Okay, so be login there in that schoolquizfit.com. Try more and more questions on that and try to get some knowledge and try to achieve some basic points from this site. We already added so many questions. Which is based on the basic part of the any chapters, and to make you understand those things, we are providing the videos also. So whatever the questions we are going to, that must be important for you, so you can understand clearly regarding any topic. Okay, so thank you everyone. We will meet in the next lectures.